In this video, I will tell you how to connect these low-voltage foot pedals to Arduino or other microcontroller, so we can read the pedal position and also detect multiple possible problems with the pedal's wiring, including the short circuit, open circuit, as well as disconnected connector. To demonstrate this, I got these PCBs from the sponsor of this video, PCBWAY.com. Whether you are buying PCBs for your own project or ones shared online, you can order them from PCBWAY.com for as low as $5 for 10 pieces of 10x10cm PCBs. Here are samples of some, but not all of the different color options you can choose from. If your project requires more advanced PCBs, 3D printed part or CNC milled part, those are available from PCBWAY.com as well. For all your prototyping and low volume production needs, go check out PCBWAY.com for up-to-date information on their offering and pricing. I recently got a second-hand sewing machine, and the previous owner also had an extra foot pedal, and even though it wasn't compatible with the machine, I was happy to take it. The previous owner had no use for it, and I wanted to have it so I could use it in my electronics projects. Different sewing machines use different kinds of foot pedals and speed controlling circuits. Some have dimmer style speed controller in the pedal, chopping the mains voltage going to the motor. Those are not the ones I'm going to use. What I'm going to use are these low voltage foot pedals, which usually have 3.5mm plug or other low voltage connector. These often are basically just variable resistors with maybe a smoothing capacitor inside. In this case, the resistance is about 1 kilo ohm when pedal is up and about 10 kilo ohm when pedal is down. Easiest way of measuring position of this or any other variable resistance input device is to connect it between ADC pin and ground. Then add pull-up resistor between that ADC pin and VCC. Pull-up resistor and variable resistor will then form a resistive voltage divider, which will output a voltage proportional to the pedal's position, and ADC can read that voltage. That's the basic circuit, which is fine for most situations. But this pedal has 3.5mm jack, and I decided to add a detection for unplugged connector. There are mono 3.5mm jacks with sense pin that is connected to the tip when plug is unplugged. I connected a resistor between that sense pin and ground with value significantly lower than the lowest resistance of the foot pedal. In this case I used 470 ohm resistor. For some reason I can't find my headphone jacks and some other connectors. I must have misplaced that assortment box at some point. This switch will be used to simulate that connector, both disconnecting the signal pin and also connecting that sense pin to tip. With these values, the output voltage range when the pedal is working is between about 0.5V and 2.5V. Voltage between those values will indicate different pedal positions. Now, if the pedal is plugged in but the wire is broken, equivalent circuit looks something like this and the output is 5V. If the pedal is plugged in and cable has short circuit, equivalent circuit looks like this and the output is 0V. Pedal unplugged, these resistors will form a voltage divider and the output will be about 0.2V. So by taking one reading with any microcontroller with the ADC, can detect the position of the pedal as well as those three error states. In this test PCB I have two output screw terminals. One example use for these foot pedals is controlling power tools. I could connect a solid state relay to one output and control a drill press motor with it, and second output could be for example for LED lights on the drill. I could then light up those LEDs when pedal is slightly pressed and turn on the drill when the pedal is all the way down. The main point of this video was to share tips on using these variable resistance foot pedals or other variable resistance input devices with microcontrollers in general. I hope this was helpful. See you next video. Thanks. Bye.